So we talked about planning, we talked about customer demand and forecasting. We haven't talked a lot about scheduling. We have to schedule things in a way, right, to coordinate where people will be, material, facilities, equipment needed to get things done. All of that has to be carefully coordinated. And the thing about scheduling is it's completely different from scheduling for production than services, because services can't be inventory, right? Restaurants can plan for customers, but they can't inventory anything outside of the products they serve. They can't inventory the service that they give. So it makes it a little bit more complex sometimes, or challenging to plan for or to schedule services. So let's talk about scheduling for services. There are a few ways you can do it. One is scheduling for peak demand. Again, we can take restaurant as a service, is considered to be in the service industry, or an airline industry considered to be in the service industry. You can schedule for what we call peak demand, right? This is a time of the year, time of the month, or the week where we know customers are going to come. Friday, Saturday, Sunday is peak demand for most restaurants. This is when a lot of people get paid. A lot of people like to go out on the weekend because they don't have to work. During the week, they usually cook more, but during the weekend is when they eat out more. So you can schedule for peak demand. Even when it comes to airlines, there are specific times where most people tend to choose to fly. That's why they discount prices during those non-peak hours, right? That's how you get other customers to fly on that red eye, because no one is on the plane. And they would rather have a full plane at 2 a.m. than to have a half a plane that they have to fly at 2 a.m. So those prices are usually less expensive. So you can schedule for peak demand. And then there's something we call chase demand. Remember, we talked about demand. It's just how much are we asking for as consumers when we talk about demand. Chase demand is literally that. The company chooses to chase demand. That's what they're doing. We're going to chase demand. So when demand is high, we plan for it. When demand is low, we plan for it. And we do this by varying the workforce or shifting the workforce. So if you're in a restaurant and it's Friday night, just got paid, everybody's coming, but you only have a handful of staff, you begin to call people to say, hey, I need you to come in to work because we have more people than we expected, right? You're varying the workforce. Now, the opposite could also be true. Friday night, people didn't get paid. No one's showing up to your restaurant, but you staff too many people. So you start sending people home. Hey, go home early, may need you tomorrow, or something like that. You're varying the workforce, but you're doing that based on customer demand. Remember, we're chasing demand. That's what chase demand is. And then there are some other methods that are also used when it comes to scheduling for services. We see that reservations is another way that some companies go. Other companies like Walmart, I see this at Kroger, grocery stores, they allow you to check yourself out, right? It's consumer self-service. They do that to free up their employees and really get free service out of us. But frankly, I would rather get 30 minutes of my day back if I didn't have to stand in a line waiting for someone to check out and I only have one or two things from the store, right? And I can go to a self-checkout. So there are other ways that scheduling for services that companies are using. So let's talk about scheduling for products. Continuous flow, batch flow, assembly line. These are different types of processes or process selection. So we know that when it comes to scheduling products, continuous flow. Continuous flow is when we're producing that same exact product over and over and over again. There's no variation. The product is exactly the same. So we can consistently produce that product without changing anything, right? And then we have the assembly line, which is there's a little bit of variation that takes place, but the product is very similar that we could still produce the exact same thing, just with slight modification. Assembly lines remind me of when I used to work at the General Motors plant. We produce minivans. Yeah, we produce minivans, but they were different colors. They had different features, different models, but essentially the same vehicle with probably 90% of the same parts, but they had slight modifications here and there, and they were produced on an assembly line. And then we have batch flow, right? This is where we produce very, very similar products still, but there's more variation. The key with batch flow, again, is that equipment changeover. This is where you have to stop doing something, change your equipment, and start back doing it. That's the key when it comes to batch flow, trying to determine the difference between a batch flow and assembly line. Assembly line almost flows continuously. You don't really have to stop it. It's just up to the employee that's doing the job to know which parts to use. So it kind of flows continuously. But when it comes to a batch, you do a batch of 10 of that, and you stop, you change the equipment, reprogram something, and then you start back. And that is how you differentiate between an assembly line and batch. So, key takeaways. When it comes to scheduling products and services, they're very similar but can be quite different because services cannot be inventoried. But scheduling is just coordinating all of the different work, people, and tasks that goes into producing a product or a service. When it comes to services, types that are used are scheduling for peak demand, chase demand, and other services like reservation or scheduling appointments or self-service checkout. And then when it comes to products, you have those process selections that we talked about in capacity planning, continuous flow, assembly line, or batch flow that requires that equipment changeover.